I know the history of Naido. Naido was a bold and strong vision to harness Nigerian ingenuity all over the world in partnership with government to see how our talents abroad can be deployed for development at home. It was to bridge the gap between our government and our people abroad. Unfortunately for Naido and for all of Nigeria, a hustling temper overtook the vision of Naido, and people thought that Naido was, they can take over Naido or be seen as very strong in Naido. From there, they would be appointed to be ministers in Nigeria. Nothing wrong with that. But that shouldn't have been the primary purpose, or DGs of parastatals or whatever. So, the virus of ambition, the virus of selfishness took over Naido, not only in Canada, not only in North America, but in many other parts of the world. Naido became a shadow of his former self. So that of Canada is not unusual. But I have thought that when I come to Canada, because I'm a passionate believer in Naido, I could in humility make a difference. And so those who went to court, and somebody wrote me a letter a few days ago, give me, and I've been a lawyer for 40 years, give me a little lecture about how when a matter is in court, ordinary human beings can no longer do anything about it, cannot. And all I was trying to do, not because I'm High Commissioner, but as a chief servant of the Nigerian community here in Canada, to say, please, let us reason together, as the book of Isaiah said. And let me hear you about your problems. Why did you even go to court? Now you are holding on the court paper and said nothing will move because you have a court paper. Where do we go from there? The first meeting was to take place in my residence over lunch. Then I was invited to Nigeria because Minister Byrne was coming. And after I could have told my own minister that I will not accept his instruction. He's not my boss, I used to be his boss. Yeah, I'm happy to have somebody who I used to be, but he's not my boss. He sat under me when he was ambassador in South Africa. Now he's the Minister of Foreign Affairs. I'm serving under him as High Commissioner in Canada. And the same loyalty he showed me when he was my High Commissioner, he deserved nothing less from me as a matter of good example. So the minister said, High Commissioner, you expected from Nigeria. I said, it's okay, I'll come. And I left. That's why the meeting didn't take place in Ottawa. I sent a letter to the people who said they are holding court paper on Naido to say, this is why I went to Nigeria. Now, I will compensate you for the effort you are going to make to come to Ottawa to have a meeting. I will now come to Toronto and visit you. And I'll call my deputy high commissioner and with other officials of the high commissioner and over lunch, let's talk about these issues and see where we can move forward. Only for me to get a very insulting letter 5 days ago saying, High Commissioner, we won't discuss with you about Naido. We have a court paper. We've been instructed by our lawyer that we must not talk with anybody because we have a court paper. In any event, the date you have given that you will talk about is not even convenient to us. And so we are giving you 4 different dates. But those dates, you have to put that in writing. This is a Nigerian writing to his High Commissioner. You have to put that in writing that when we meet, you won't discuss Naido. That our meeting with you will just be a courtesy visit. I got that letter 5 days ago. Now, I want to tell those people who think that because they got a court paper that gave Naido to them, let them eat their Naido paper. Nigeria is higher than any individual. Yes. I work with those Nigerians who realize that beyond the piece of paper called Naido, there is the national interest which can still survive even in any other form that is not NIDO.
Yeah.
It can survive through MBBM, it can survive through NCA, it can survive even by another name. We agree that if my peace effort fails, we should go ahead and reorganize the vision of the federal government of Nigeria that inspired NIDO in any other form or name.
Yeah.
That doesn't have to be. So let me come to your record to say that for as long as I am here in Canada, and I hope those who will take over from me, they should be supported also in this direction. That all those people who are holding on to the fig leaf of a paper to denigrate their motherland, they will be treated as the pariahs and the outcasts they are to the Nigerian society. Invited by any Nigerian group, and I get a hint that any of those characters are there, I walk out from the ceremony. Now, I'm talking not just as a diplomat, I'm talking as a Nigerian with red blood in his veins. Totally outraged about how anybody can insult his country. Because such a letter to the High Commissioner is not an insult to the High Commissioner of his office, it's an insult to President Jonathan. It's an insult to the all Nigerian people. Got to show a little more discipline. We allow things to happen with impunity. We don't condemn.
Yeah.
We don't punish.
Yeah.
We just say, no, leave it like that.
Okay.
And we don't recognize when people do the right thing. We must begin to return Nigeria to a country of incentive,
yes,
where right doing is applauded and celebrated and honored.
Yes.
And mischief and rascality is visited with opprobrium. Thank you, Adonis.